हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर शादाब अहमद मोहम्मद, कंसल्टेंट कार्डियोलॉजिस्ट एट केयर हॉस्पिटल्स मलकपेट हैदराबाद। सो टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग एन इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट इज कार्डियक एरिथमियाज, दैट इज अबनॉर्मलिटीज इन द कार्डियक हार्ट रेट। सो नॉर्मली पर्सन्स बॉडी हैज़ अ हार्ट रेट ऑफ अराउंड 60 to 100 बीट्स पर मिनट। सो अ हार्ट हैज़ टू पम्प अराउंड 60 to 100 टाइम्स इन अ मिनट टू पम्प द ब्लड टू द एंटायर बॉडी। So whenever any dysfunction occurs in this heart rate, it can lead to cardiac arrhythmias, which can again lead to dysfunction of the cardiac muscle. So there are two important terms to understand, that is bradycardia and tachycardia. So when you have a low heart rate, which is less than 60 beats per minute, it is called as bradycardia. And when you have a high heart rate, which is more than 100 beats per minute, it is called as tachycardia. So there are various important causes which can lead to this abnormal heart rate. Commonly what we see is in bradycardia, that is low heart rate, it may be due to any congenital heart disease or with increased age due to calcium deposition in the normal pacemaker of your body, it can lead to low heart rate, which blocks the conduction in the normal arrhythmic system. And when the tachycardia occurs, it has various other causes like any dysfunction in the heart muscle, or again it can also have some genetic causes and due to various drugs or medicines which can lead to tachycardia. And one most important cause of tachycardia, that is sinus tachycardia, is any discomfort to your body. So any person who has fever or any stress to the body can have tachycardia, that is heart rate of more than 100 beats per minute. So normally when the bradycardia or tachycardia occurs and there is no symptom, it does not need any treatment. The common symptoms due to bradycardia or tachycardia can be palpitations or lightheadedness, that is giddiness, or a patient can have a fainting attack, which is called as syncope. Other common symptoms due to bradycardia or tachycardia are difficulty in breathing and chest pain. So when coming to the treatment of bradycardia and tachycardia, so these two mechanisms, that is the terms, that is bradycardia and tachycardia, they need different treatment. So when one has a low heart rate, it can commonly lead to fainting attacks and difficulty in breathing, so it needs to be treated. So when the heart rate is less than 60 beats per minute and if it is due to abnormal conduction, then the patient may need some drug therapy initially to control or bring up the heart rate. Whereas if the symptoms are not controlled and if it is due to irreversible causes like due to aging or degenerative causes, then the patient may need pacemaker, which is a device which maintains your heart rate. And coming to tachycardia, so when you have ruled out the reversible factors which can lead to tachycardia and there are some non-modifiable factors which can lead to tachycardia, so the tachycardia is again divided into broad terms. Like it can be ventricular tachycardia or supraventricular tachycardia, which is abnormal, and sinus tachycardia, which is normal, which is due to some reversible factors. So when you have supraventricular and ventricular tachycardia, then you need drug treatment initially to control your heart rates. Whereas if the person has experienced a fainting attack, which is syncope due to ventricular tachycardia, and he has experienced a term called as aborted sudden cardiac death, then the person needs a device which is called as automated implantable cardioverter defibrillator. So which is like a device which gives shocks in the heart and controls the tachycardia. So because ventricular tachycardia is a life-threatening disease, and especially if it is not due to reversible factors, then you may need this device called as AICD. Then there are various other diseases which can also lead to tachycardia and bradycardia, like which is due to heart muscle disease like myocarditis or heart failure. So in these conditions also, you may initially need some medical therapy, and if the tachycardia is not controlled due to medical therapy and if it is recurrent and if it leads to sudden collapse, then you may need this device called as AICD. Recognizing tachycardias and bradycardia in a patient is very important. So symptoms are very non-specific and can be just palpitations or difficulty in breathing. So to recognize these symptoms, we commonly do an ECG, and if the ECG is not showing any problem, then we can go for a long term recording with of the tachycardia or bradycardia events, which may be over 24 hours, that is Holter monitoring, or it can be over 7 days with a loop recorder. So if you properly treat this bradycardia and tachycardia events, then there won't be any increased mortality and morbidity. So recognizing the problem is important, and there are various treatment including drug therapy and device therapies to control this tachycardia and bradycardia events. Thank you.